Hey there, welcome back to Popular Crime. And if you are new to our channel, welcome. I'm Heather, and today we're looking into the modern mystery of Devil's Kettle Falls. Located inside Judge Magni State Park in Minnesota, where the water flows from this waterfall has puzzled geologists for years. Located on the northern shore of Lake Superior in Minnesota, a spectacular waterfall called Devil's Kettle Falls flows from the Brule River. As the water flows, it splits into an east side and a west side. The east side flows straight down and eventually meets up with Lake Superior. The west side flows into a large kettle, or pothole, and seems to vanish into the unknown. Now, the sheer volume of water that flows every day surely has to go somewhere, right? Let's take a look inside. First, you see the east side, which flows normally. Here's the west side, and when you peer inside it, it seems to be flowing somewhere, but nobody knows where. For years, this has perplexed geologists and researchers in the area, and they've thrown many things into the kettle, like ping pong balls, logs, food dyes, pretty much anything that could be used to track an object to determine where it ends up flowing to. And every time objects are put in there, they vanish without a trace. Now, one thought about where the water goes is to an undiscovered underground river system. Perhaps there are subterranean caves under there. The only problem is that the geology in the area suggests otherwise. One, deep caves and channels like this are actually pretty rare. Two, typically the kind of rock that would be needed to create such a meandering tunnel system would be limestone. Limestone is a softer rock and it's very porous, and it's not located in this area. What is common here are layers and layers of rhyolite and basalt. These are much harder rocks and don't wear away as easily to create the kind of tunnel system that would be needed to move the water from the kettle to the lake. And by the way, you can see the rhyolite right here where the Brule River splits and the falls divide. Now, it's possible for an underground river to form from seismic activity along a fault line, but there are no known fault lines here. And even if there were, it would have to be massive to be able to move that kind of volume of falling water. Another theory for a while was that maybe there's a lava tube underneath the waterfall that leads to the lake. Well, while the rocks in the area are volcanic in origin, they are not known to be able to form lava tubes in the caliber it would need to move all of this water. Rhyolite is not known to form lava tubes. Basalt can, but only certain types. For basalt lava tubes, it has to be flowing down a slope from a volcano. And in this particular area, the basalt is known as flood basalt. This kind of basalt seeps out of volcanic fissures in the ground and form wide flat sheets of rock, which are not known to form lava tubes. It's also located deep underground, so no structures like this have been found in this area yet. And if it did exist unknown to us between storms and erosion, at some point the underground system would clog. Let's take a look at this article here from Treehugger. In February 2017, the Minnesota Department of Natural Resources said that water that disappears into the rock at Devil's Kettle resurges in the stream below the waterfall. Hydrologists compared the amount of water flowing above the waterfall with the amount flowing below it to see if some water was lost somewhere between the two locations. In fall 2016, the DNR reports hydrologists measured the water flow above Devil's Kettle at 123 cubic feet per second. While several hundred feet below the waterfall, the water is flowing at 121 cubic feet per second. Quote, in the world of stream gauging, those two numbers are essentially the same and are within the tolerances of the equipment, end quote, said DNR springshed mapping hydrologist Jeff Green in a statement. Quote, the readings show no loss of water below the kettle, so it confirms the water is resurging in the stream below it, end quote. To confirm their theory, researchers plan on conducting a dye trace in fall of 2017 during a low water flow period. They'll pour a vegetable-based dye into the pothole and watch where the water resurfaces. So that sounds interesting. The only problem is that the researchers never returned in the fall to conduct the dye trace to confirm their theory. The reason? They didn't feel like there was a scientific reason to confirm their theory. They made a statement basically saying that they're comfortable with the monitoring that they did to check the water flow levels earlier in the year. So, does the DNR's explanation of the water resurfacing make sense? Is it enough to definitively say where all that water goes? Or does this pothole lead to another dimension or the upside down? Let me know what you think in the comments down below. But that is going to do it for today. If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to hit that notification bell so you don't miss any of our uploads. As always, stay safe, keep investigating, and we'll see you soon.